I'll turn my attention to Ankit, more on the fiber, and we heard Mr. R.S. Sharma talking about the fact that we need a hybrid mix, the importance of fiber in a country where we have very few fixed line connections, and therefore what steps you are taking to look at it from a more integrated model. It's not just wireless, but wireline and wireless together.
So I just want to thank CII and to invite Sterlite for this forum, for this discussion. While we get the presentation sorted out, I just felt this is a fascinating time for this discussion to happen. You have very interesting things going on in the US with the elections and the implications for that. You have Brexit happening. And I believe in India, we have the digital infrastructure getting built like never before. And I think we're uniquely placed that the kind of infrastructure that will get built in India next 3 to 5 years, I think that would have never happened anywhere in the world before. So my presentation is, yes, there are challenges. Yes, there are issues both from the past and current. But I think whatever we see as Sterlite, we're really optimistic. I think we have excellent support from the government. One of the first statements our Prime Minister said is that this government will be known for digital highways, and a tremendous amount of effort is being going into the Digital India project. It's part of PMO weekly review now, and clearly the government is looking at this very, very closely. I'd just like to add that the challenges, while they are quite unique to India, I believe a lot of the solutions will come from partnerships with leading companies from the US and other countries as well. And so we really look forward to working closely with companies from all other countries. Thank you. Just in interest of time, I won't spend too much time about Sterlite Technologies. But broadly, we have the largest manufacturing presence in the country, top five in the world for the optic fiber, and manufacturing in India, China, and Brazil. We're quite heavily focused on R&D, and about 100 patents already, another 50, 60 that we're working on. In terms of the opportunity that I spoke earlier about, I truly believe that it is an end-to-end infrastructure that is getting built out in this country. A lot is getting spoken about the 4G. I think this is an incredible deployment that's happening in the country. I can speak both on the wireless and the wired side. Tremendous effort by all the operators in the country, as well as with Reliance Jio coming on board. Tremendous network which is getting built, not just now but also for the next 3 to 5 years that we see. Smart cities, again, 100 smart cities announced and already working on by the government. There's a short list already of, I believe, 33 cities. Absolutely all the states are very clear that a fiber network and a connected network has to be at the center of all these smart cities. Rural broadband, I think an incredible project by our government under BharatNet. Yes, there have been delays. Yes, there have been challenges, but I can easily see that the government is absolutely committed to making the project happen. There are two or three phases, but I'm absolutely convinced that with the center and state working together, there will be a solution to this. The defense is also working on an incredible network connecting all of the Navy and Army on a dedicated MPLS network, which is also posing an incredible network which is getting built out. And also, of course, Sterlite, but also other Indian players, we're working on international markets as well. So just Sterlite itself is providing fiber connectivity in over 70 countries currently. So working with the Indian map, we believe right at top is Digital India. We have also Make in India and Skill India. All of this is connected to broadband and connectivity. We spoke earlier and we heard a little bit about broadband as an essential utility. And again, here I see this absolutely falls in line with the theme of the event, which is best practices. So US has been absolutely leading the pack in the first It went all the way, I believe, to High Court or Supreme Court, where they announced recently that it is an essential utility. And a lot of the operators are having different views, but this is an incredible place where US is taking the lead. So I just wanted to summarize three or four areas where we see the US already taking a lead in terms of best practices. Number one, it has approved 25 Mbps as the official definition of broadband. And it took that, where it was earlier 4 Mbps, it took a view that no, it has to be almost six times higher. And so now the official broadband definition is 25 Mbps. I think that's a great step forward by the US government and sets a precedent for all of us to look at. India, it's currently 512 kbps, and already there is some work and some consultations out of how to hopefully bring that up to 4 or 10 at least for a country like India. Second one is it's already approved spectrum for 5G. I think that's already, again, a great step forward. And we have some numbers I'll show, but clearly a huge amount of network needs to get built out. And a first step by the government of approving the spectrum for 5G as a future looking is a great step. There are standard rules for right of way, and what was discussed earlier also by Amy was about the Dig One policy. This is an absolute no-brainer for India to deploy. While there are challenges to actually execute it, I believe Minister will be coming later, Mr. J.S. Deepak, already working on a policy document, which I think is path-breaking. He's talking about how effectively all the states will provide the right of way at a fair cost. And within 2 months, if it is not approved, then it's deemed approved. So excellent policy in the making. Just very quickly on the broadband, we all know that the penetration in the country is limited, but that's really where we see the tremendous opportunity. We talked about broadband as utility. The government is clearly looking at broadband as utility. And in fact, one of the things which Gozal talked about is also something that Sterlite's working on. We're actively looking at all the other infrastructure pieces in the country, which is on the power and the water in particular, and how fiber networks can be deployed alongside these networks. We're already seeing a lot of interest from the telecom operators to take up some of these fiber networks as long as we can deploy these fiber in the key cities. And from the government perspective also, I wanted to just share that the budget for telecom is increasing year on year. Historically, it was more towards the energy and the transport. But as you can see, the green part, this telecom budget is also increasing for the next 2-3 years. I won't spend too much time on this, but just wanted to give everyone a sense. We hear of a wide range of numbers, but broadly between 15 to 17x 15 to 17 times is the data growth in the next 5 years. So clearly the growth is there. As we talked about, the handsets and the data rates are going to start falling. Analysts are predicting that from about 23 paise per MB, it will come down to about 10 paisa per MB. And who knows what Reliance Jio will do, but it could fall even further. This just talking about the data consumption per subscriber. Currently, it's around 130 to 140, and we are seeing clearly there is a room for this for a 10x or maybe 20x growth in terms of data usage. So we believe that clearly by getting users at the right price point, at the rate, at the right handset prices, we believe that this will have an exponential jump in data consumption. Just want to spend 2 minutes on this slide because it's something that really surprises people. On the left is the population, which I think all of you would be aware. We have the US, then we have India, we have China. But what's really interesting is we mapped out the cumulative fiber that has been deployed since history for these countries. Just to give people a sense of the digital divide and the experience divide that Gulzar talked about. So the US is about 400 to 450 million of fiber kilometers deployed. I'll come to India last. China has about a billion fiber kilometers deployed already. And India is about 100 million. So clearly there is a 10x difference already in terms of a real digital divide that exists between India and China. So while I would only argue that while we keep debating on GDP growth, whether it's 6%, 7%, I think we should also talk about the real 10x digital divide that exists between India and China. And of course, US has been deploying fiber networks for several years. Verizon and AT&T are leaders globally. But clearly, there is a tremendous opportunity here for the Indian networks to be built out. At the bottom is also something that we'd like to highlight. Is something that people need to understand that it's not wireless or wired. Everything works in parallel and works together, in fact. In terms of fiber connectivity, we see that while in the past, maybe 2 to 5% of towers could be backhauled using fiber, as you move versus 3G and 4G and, of course, 5G, this proportion starts increasing substantially. So already what we're seeing is in tier one countries like Japan, Korea, and even US, you already anywhere between 60% to 80%. And for the nations to start getting ready for 5G, which is only 4 to 5 years away, we will need 100% fiberization. So a huge push is already on the works in India, but clearly a long way to go. Just wanted to touch upon one more opportunity which we see in India. On the left-hand side, we see a tremendous opportunity for building fiber to the home. And again, here I'd like to share that we are significantly behind the rest of the world. Just to give you a sense, China has already deployed about 200 to 250 million fiber to the homes connected and homes passed. And in India, we are out. The numbers are, you know, anywhere between say 5 to 7 million are probably the numbers that we're expecting over the next 1 or 2 years. The good news is that all the operators are now actively looking at this. So both in our discussions, we see at least 2 or 3 operators like Vodafone, Jio, Airtel, and even Idea actively looking at now connecting fiber to the home and really capturing the value of high-speed connectivity. And this we see as a huge experience. We see experience will go from 3 to 5 Mbps that you get now to really 50 Mbps and 100 Mbps as well. And so we're hoping Google Fiber will also do something interesting in India and maybe provide 1 Gbps. Just a last slide in terms of the summary of the market opportunities. Broadly, we see $20 to $25 billion of opportunities in the next 5 years. This is across defense, BharatNet, the public sector, as well as the smart cities. And this is our own estimates from what we see in the market. But when we've compared this to the infrastructure rollout of other countries, and we do believe that some estimates like the number of the quantum of ICT in smart cities will be quite significant. And similarly, we have a revised budget for BharatNet, which is close to about $9 billion. Just wanted to add that Indian companies are also playing a critical role in sharing global best practices. We are actively member of the FTTH Council, the ITU, Bureau of Indian Standards, TEC, Telecordia, Indian Broadband Forum. We're also working on some interesting things with Facebook on the Open Compute Project and the Telecom Infrastructure Project. So just happy to share that India and Indian companies are playing a global role in looking at best practices and the global standards. So just wanted to summarize with saying that I really appreciate being invited to this forum, and I truly believe that partnerships amongst the people present here, we can solve India's connectivity problems. Thank you.
Thank you, Ankit. Very comprehensive presentation, and also bringing out the opportunity for fiber, both in terms of fiber to the home and so also the fiberized towers, where you have brought out very well the hybrid complexion of the networks which we have, yes, between wireless and fiber. Thank you very much indeed.